Hey, Pumpkin. He was finally awake. This one's been asleep all day. Say hello to everybody, Pumpkin. There's always comments if I don't make sure to show you in the videos. Look over here. Over here. Give us a kiss. No kiss? Okay, thanks, Pumpkin. Such a sweetheart. Yeah, you too, Toby. You're such a sweetheart too, Toby. Good boy, Toby. All the pets. Well, a bunch of them. Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here. How's everybody doing? I hope you're doing well. I am great. Fantastic. It's a nice day. Cold day. Very cool day, but weather's all right. Lots of overcast, which means good time for a garden tour. That probably doesn't mean anything to anybody else. It's a lot easier to get better shots of the plants without the sun, like, blazing down on everything. Harsh light, not great for videos. Off and on, misting a big part of the day, but I think it finally stopped that umbrella. Look at that wonky umbrella. There's a new one coming in the mail. Should be here hopefully in a few days. Things are coming around. I'm enjoying the view. Things are looking good. I love that I can see the scrub palms through the window. Ginger's coming up, croton right there. The window's not dirty. I don't want to hear anything about the dirty windows. It's in between the panes. Have to like actually tear this out and replace the windows. Like there is a vapor seal inside these that went bad. That's all vlog type stuff. Let's go outside and look at the garden. Oh, of course. The very second I'm about to go outside, you're gonna jump up and make me feel so bad about it. I'm sorry, Pumpkin. She did not want to come to bed last night, so she slept down here. She's never not slept in my bedroom before, unless I was like out of town and not here. So first time in 9 years she got locked out, and she wasn't happy about it. I wasn't too happy about it either, but I was tired. So sorry I left you out. I fell asleep. I meant to come back and get her. Instead, I fell asleep. Pumpkin, why you always gotta put your pumpkin on camera, Pumpkin? Yeah, let's go outside. See what the plants are doing. Any interest? Would you like to join? Toby, you coming? Nothing? Toby, come on. Let's go outdoors. Here you go. Good boy, Toby. Grab this so everybody's not shaking all over the place. I suppose a good amount of things have changed out here since last garden tour, because that was in March. So, like, none of this was here back in March. In that tour, I did spend a good amount of time talking about plans and projects and things I wanted to do. And here we are in May. It's June by the time this video comes out. A few days behind with some stuff, but most of those things haven't happened. I got really excited about just having the plants out here, and that became my main focus, was just handling my house plants, the tropical plants, getting the mulch off of things, and haven't gotten around to the big stuff quite yet. Still gotta baby step things because, you know, the whole situation with the shoulder that went on last year, and I gotta be careful this year, not overdo things, so just taking my sweet time. Got all season to get things done, right? This entire area over here has become more of my repotting station. One of them, when I brought all the houseplants outside, the bulk of them I put over here in this area because it's fairly shady. It's just morning sun, so the plants can slowly acclimate to the light, just get them hardened off and ready for summer. And anything that's needed repotting, there's potting soil in this wheelbarrow here. I've been digging in here and dealing with those. It's also become a stand for a cactus. It's very heavy and needs a new pot. The glider has become a place where I store things. I never sit in it anyways, just doing mosquitoes over here. So these are basically what's left on my repot, or need to put new hooks on some of those orchids that are over there. But the main thing that's going on over here, well, that's not a good view. Put that down. See if that makes things any better. Is that better? Eh, kind of. So I talked about moving these pedicets, the pedicets japonicus. There's the variegated ones in here, and then the regular ones, or whatever these were called. I did a whole video on them. Really big ones and then smaller ones. I need to relocate these big guys here. See, they're just too big. They're shading out all the variegated ones below, and I just haven't gotten around to it yet. That's something I do have to get on top of though, because this is a plant that doesn't transplant very well if you do it when it's really warm outside. It's pretty chilly right now for May. It's still May right now. I think today's May 31st. It's pretty cool. It's like 62 degrees. I'm not used to that. I even had to move some plants inside a few days ago, the lows were in the lower 40s. So that would be fine for doing some transplanting. And the extended forecast looks like it may not be up into the 80s and 90s for maybe another 7 to 10 days. I would prefer they have a few weeks with cooler temperatures before transplanting. So we'll see if I can get around to it fast enough. These are the big ones that are right here are going to be removed just from this spot. I'm gonna let them continue to grow up this hill here. You can't really see them. I was gonna keep talking. I thought, why not come over here where you can see them?
they'll keep going up the hill. I'm fine with that. But I did want to get this area cleared out. I may put some impatiens in here. We will see. I have a big or several big flats of them. If they don't go right here, then they're going to go over here, which is another area that I've been doing a lot of work on. So that's why it's a disaster. The soil over here became just filled with gravel and giant chunks of clay. It hasn't been draining well. So I've been turning it slowly. I think I've gone in three times now. Been in there trying to keep it turned and adding things to it so that it will drain a little better, and trying to slowly kind of sift some of that gravel out and pull it forward. I have some, what is this? I got these last year on clearance and forgot what they were called. Rainbow Sensation Weigela. Can you even see that? I don't know if you can, but they have really fun foliage on them. These have been through a lot. A lot of the plants that are out here have been through a lot this year because the weather was just really erratic this spring. Around most of the U.S., that's how it was. It would be really warm for a few days and then unseasonably cold for a few days. There's some damage on here. At least these weigelas did do some flowering, so that's nice. But the snow, we had snow in late April. So what I was saying is this area is basically hopefully getting a big facelift this year. I'll be moving some of these tripod. I'll move some of these pedicets from over here back into that area. Over here, this area here, and then filling in with some impatiens here, and then back again over there. Cushions are all getting cleaned up and washed professionally. I did lose the orange tree. I've had people ask me about it. I dug this up last year and it was doing okay throughout the majority of the winter, and then we had that cold snap where it was 5 degrees below zero for several days, and it was like 2 weeks of just, I think, below 10. Horrible freezing temperatures. I cut it back to the point where there's still just a hint of green inside those trunks. So I'm hopeful that maybe there's some life in there. I do have it on drip, so it's getting regular irrigation. So, you know, if there's anything that can be done for it, it's being done. We'll just have to wait and see. I'm hopeful, but it just is what it is. Hopefully it's alive. If not, I don't know. I'm not crying over dead plants. Weather's out of all of our controls, right? It wasn't a plant that was small enough for me to be able to move, especially back in February. Wouldn't have gone anywhere near that in February. This plant has gigantic thorns on it. It's a very dangerous plant. And I had a skin graft and a lot of delicate skin. I wouldn't know. I wasn't going anywhere near that thing to do much to protect it. I threw a frost cloth over it, actually two frost cloths over it, and just hope for the best. And, well, that didn't happen. Pretty sure it's dead. Queen palms are here. Looking good, looking pretty. The Washingtonia does have some foliage that needs to be cut off. Not a self-cleaning palm, so gonna need to find my tree trimmers, my tree pruners. Not find them. I know where they are. They're just broken. I need to fix them. I thought about getting new ones, and then I saw how much they cost. I was like, whoa, I'm gonna be duct taping mine back together. I'm not spending $90 on a stick with a razor blade on it. Another area that I haven't done anything with yet, but some fun things are hopefully planned for this spot. Buckeye getting big. It actually has buckeyes on it for the first time ever. I've had this plant for years, many, many, many years. Do the camera doesn't like buckeyes? Apparently not. I'll back up a little bit. That doesn't help much. Well, they just look like brownstones. It's not that exciting. I like these buckeyes. This is the red buckeye. I like them because they have really interesting foliage. It's similar to like the hardy varieties of Scheffleras, but much more cold hardy. This should be good down to zone 5. This is the red variety. Grandma's death bench, still up there. That's gonna get thrown out pretty soon. I could explain what I mean there, but I'm not going to. I'll just let the mystery stand. Pukara container, looking great. I need to put a centerpiece in this, don't I? It's in this gigantic pot. Well, it's not gigantic. That's probably, I think it's a 24-inch pot. It's pretty hefty and heavy. But it's a beautiful pot. I love all the dimples that are on the side. It's really cute. I think that would be nice with something coming up out of the center. They have just the heuchera. Although those heuchera are so pretty. Trying to remember what varieties are in here. This one back here is called like guacamole, I believe. It's not from a particular grower, so I don't have a tag on it. This one right here is Primo Wild Rose, and this one is Peach Berry Ice. And the Peach Berry Ice, when the sun gets on this, when they get more sun, they get a really, really pretty intense color to them. I just like the color combination here. Primo Rose still has some nice looking flowers on it. The guacamole's done flowering, and the Peach Berry Ice, I think, is just now getting started. It has like one tiny itty bitty little flower on it. Another thing I talked about in the last garden tour was what I was going to do with these great big hydrangea trees here. Pardon the mess. We'll talk about that in a minute. I had mentioned that this one over here needs to be repotted, but The problem is finding big containers is really tricky right now. I repotted this other one last year. I think it was last year. I'm pretty sure it was. Yeah, it was last year. And this is in a 30-inch container. There's going to be weeds. There's lots of weeding to be done. There's little maple trees and things out here everywhere. Right, a gardening. Right. Anyways, so I gave these a heavy prune, used the flower tone on them, which I had never done before. Laura, Garden Answers, had talked about using flower tone on woody perennials and stuff. Or rose tone. I'm sorry, I used rose tone on them. Which made sense because it's made for woody perennials and that's what these are. The growth I'm getting out of them already is just so much more than I've ever seen out of them before. This one back here, that's gonna be like at least 7.5, maybe 8 feet tall, including the pot, but that's like way up there. Anyways, backtracking. That one already in a big pot. This one right here still needs a big pot. The magnolia planter, that magnolia died back during the late snow freeze thing that we had back in April. It still has some life in it, but not much. So the best thing to do for this magnolia would be to get out of this pot, get it into the ground, and wouldn't you know, well, you can't tell from right here. It's a pot that matches the other one. The color's different, but I can paint them, make them match, and then I've solved that problem. Instead of relocating these, I'm gonna go ahead and repot this one right here into that pot. I'll spray paint it first, get both of those painted in some way, color, tone, something, so that they look a little bit better. I really do love these blue pots that are over here, though, because look at them with the Creeping Jenny. I mean, isn't that just beautiful? That's what I love about Creeping Jenny. The way it trails, it has a movement to it that reminds me of water, the way it moves and it spreads. Pardon the cactus, that Nepali cactus, I just kind of toss bits of those around for the tortoise to rummage and snack on while he's out here. That's not Creeping Jenny and cactus, that's probably not a good pairing. One likes a lot of water, one doesn't want much at all. That's why those are there. Yeah, this entire spot right here though, I just think looks so pretty. Even though I can see there's some dead stuff I need to clean out from the winter time, it just makes me smile. It makes my heart smile really big. So I will more than likely be trying to color both of these pots some form of blue. The problem is blue, when it comes to like spray paints and roll-on paints, it just doesn't tend to look anywhere near as nice as it does when it's actually on like a glazed pot, because things are kind of monotoned. I like for blue to have dimension. Like this, there's whites and there's blacks and all different colors mixed in there. So it might be a bit of an art project, which at the painting's not really my thing. I don't have a ton of patience for it, but I'm gonna see what I can do so that those look nice and we'll be able to have this gorgeous Creeping Jenny coming down the sides on both ends here. So while I had said that I was planning on relocating the paniculata hydrangeas, they're just, I don't know, I miss having them back here. They would have had to go to my front yard. So I think since I have a matching pot, I'm gonna try and make it work for one more year. The issue's been the sunlight. These trees are growing, they're not getting quite enough light. I don't think that'll be a big issue this year. Look at the honeysuckle. So pretty, major wheeler, honeysuckle. Just like by half a second missed two hummingbirds that were over here on them. Hummingbirds love them. Gorgeous flowers, some of my favorites. They remind me of like the Gartenmeister fuchsias, which one of those I have is looking beautiful. I gotta remember to show that in this tour too. But it's coming up nicely, starting to fill things out here. I moved a small portion from this clump and the clump that's on the other side of this arch here. There's some Japanese honeysuckle coming up there I need to pull out. Just noticed that. I moved some of that over to my fence. And that'll look pretty in a few years. It's gonna take a while to get going. I got lots of plants stocked up down here that I've actually made a big, big, big dent in this. These are just things I'm working with this year, things that need to get planted up. I did, unfortunately, have an incident with the drip. I had 1, 2, 3, 4 flats that almost completely rotted out. We had a bunch of rain, but this spot's somewhat sheltered. There's a wax myrtle right above here to cast some shade down onto everything, or a northern bayberry, sorry, not a wax myrtle. Similar, but not the same. Anyways, I have drip lines underneath this gravel here that carry all the water to that side of the yard, and apparently there's a crack in one of the lines, so all the flats that were right over here and right here just saturated. Almost completely rotted out. They think they maybe still have some hope. I went ahead and I cut them back. I'm gonna go and get them planted up because I think that would be their best bet, but that's not that great. It was just petunias though. Not the end of the world, but hopefully I'll be able to bring some life back to them. So they're looking pretty sad by the time I realized that they were, well, that they were rotten. They're really gross looking. Lantana tree starting to flush out with a fresh set of buds, which I'm really excited about. It stopped a few weeks ago I've been waiting for it to get going again. It's looking nice. This is how we're blocking the view of my Japanese maple bonsai. And that's okay. This is temporary. That's just the holding spot. Need to get that moved. I planted that have a whole bunch of gingers and things down here that are basically just waiting for things to warm up. And those will get planted. I could probably do that probably in the next week or so, I would think. The ground's plenty warm. I think I'm just being a little bit chicken and nervous about some of the things and getting them into the ground. Now this whole area over here, this all got planted up in last weekend's vlog, right? Yeah, that was just last weekend. So I haven't done anything different with this area than what was in that video. There's a hibiscus here that needs to be cut back and repotted. Same thing over here. There's a little yellow lollipop plant right here. This Pakistaki's lutea. Got crispy from getting too much light, but I didn't really care because this needs like a 50%. Trim, and I think that that'll flush back out nicely. The Bismarck palm, see that just the pretty bluish gray leaf back there? I love that palm. It's doing really well. This entire area is actually, it's doing well. Right after I finished filming last weekend's video, it just got cold and fairly rainy, so not much has happened over here. The plants just sort of been sitting here, but I made sure to get that video filmed so it'd be out over a week from when I filmed this one, so hopefully if there's any growth we would see it, but nah, not enough time for that, at least not with those cool temperatures. I have very much been enjoying this centerpiece here. It's so pretty. Makes me so happy. Love these caladiums. I wasn't able to find an answer for what they are, and there's so many varieties of caladiums. It seems like almost like a waste of time to guess if it's not labeled. So for now, I just figure we'll just sit back and wait and watch them grow, see if they keep up this really neat foliage. The foliage on these, so pretty. Their smaller growth has been coming out white, but that's how they were when I got them. It's just the big leaves that have been like this. So maybe that's old leaves. I don't know. No idea, but I really like them. And if they end up just being white like this, I'll still like them. I don't think there's any caladium that I don't like. They're all really fun, beautiful plants. The begonias that I put back here, those actually have surprisingly done a fair amount of growing in just the week that they were in here. But these were the two that are in this planter, I should say. They were ready to get repotted. They were way too big for their nursery containers. They were in like just little 2 or maybe 4 inch containers. So they're doing really well. They're happy back here. One of my alocasias back here. It's one of my variegated ones. Need to do some cleanup on that. Leaves are still coming up variegated and still looking pretty. There's a lot of construction going on, guys. I'm sorry about the background noise. Rager begonia. Isn't it pretty? I just love it. Okay. And this area is here where I left off in the vlog from last week. I believe it's where I left off anyways in last week's vlog. I got the aucubas framing this fountain here, which you'll be able to see better. The fan wasn't in the way and I moved the Thai constellation monstera back behind that. I was nervous about that just because I've never kept it over here this time of year, and usually the sun in the morning comes through pretty strong, but it doesn't seem to mind. I did end up moving the fuchsias back up here on this lamp just because they provide shade in just the right spot to a really big leaf that's back there. That one leaf right behind my finger was getting pretty direct sun for a long time the first morning this was out here, so that's why I hung that fuchsia back up there, and that did the trick, shaded it just fine, and seems to be doing well there. I like having it over here. I also moved my Medinilla plant over here because it's in bloom. That's a plant that I want front and center when it's in bloom because I love those flowers. The way they cascade down, I think, looks so pretty. Such a fun bright pink color, and it has, I think, 2 more spikes popping up on it, so it should be in flower for a while. I'm gonna have to watch the water over here though, because my drip is set up as misters and sprayers, because I have a lot of like anthuriums and things, like little plants back there that need that constant moisture and humidity. But the Medinilla, I don't think it's going to need that. So that is something I hadn't really thought about. I'm gonna have to keep an eye on it. I just moved that this morning. So right after I set it up there, I went, oh wait, I don't know. Maybe it wasn't a great idea. I have to keep an eye on it. The one thing with last week's video with these aucubas, I originally had them in the pots with these bamboo, the yellow bamboo, and then I was talking about whether I should leave them there, and they decided ultimately to pull them out. There were originally 2 in each one of these pots, these big blue pots, and I had some people asking and saying that 2 would be too many for those pots, and I realized that I forgot to even mention that the aucubas couldn't be planted in those permanently because they're not fully hardy here. There's usually about 2 or 3 weeks during the winter time where I have to lift those and pull them and bring them inside when it gets below like 10 degrees. They can take the cold in zone 6 if they're in a sheltered spot, but containers are much more exposed. They're still in containers, so they wouldn't have been permanently planted in there anyways. That would have just been like a for 1 year kind of thing. But it didn't matter. I think they were going to get too much light over there as it was. So I pulled them out, put them over here. Some are going to go back over where that bench was that I was talking about. And then a couple I'll just be keeping to have around for some interest and some color during the winter time. That was the thinking with the bamboo. It looked beautiful all those years that I had the bird of paradise in those pots, but I really wanted something that would be potentially evergreen. Yellow bamboo does tend to brown out quite a bit where I live during the winter time. But provide privacy. I think they look nice. They have a lot of movement in the wind. There's just something kind of calm and tranquil about them that I really enjoy. And I won't have to be lifting those giant bird of paradise plants in and out of these containers every single fall. It was worth it. It was worth the work getting them in and out of those pots. But I think the bamboo is a better way to go. So it can stay in there year round and keep growing and look nice. Eventually we get to a point where I have to divide it up and do some cutbacks and repots and things like that, but that's a few years down the road. I don't have to worry about that quite yet. Coral Sunrise Exotica Series Ivy Geranium. Absolutely love these. All my geraniums are sort of in that awkward stage where they're covered in lots of old dead flowers and getting ready to flush out with new ones, but this one, I don't know what it is. There's something about it just makes me really happy. I miss the foliage. Kind of similar to that guacamole hookera, a little bit. It's a lighter, sort of a chartreuse green, gorgeous coral flowers on them. It's a nice contrast. And I love coral. Coral flowers are so pretty. This adenidia container I was getting ready to work on, decided that I needed to tap the brakes and get this video filmed. So here's where I've left off. Haven't potted anything up yet, but that's kind of just the nature of gardening, right? Especially on a gardening channel. I'm going to be working on planting things all season. Just getting going here. I'm going to put some begonias in here. Maybe some lantana. I haven't decided yet. Gorgeous Maligold Colocasia back there. And this one. Isn't it so cool? Look how neat these look together. It's kind of loud and extreme, but I don't hate it. Pseudoanthemum Black Varnish. Perfect name for this plant, right? Absolutely stunning foliage. Look at that leaf. Isn't that cool? Came out half and half, looking neat. 12 to 18 inches high, sun to part shade, grown for foliage, keeps soil evenly moist. Sounds easy enough to me. This has been doing great since I got it. I've just been making sure it gets a drink, and that's it. In person, I don't know how it's going to look on the screen, but in person, it is more on like a chocolatey red, kind of like, have you ever seen like a Merlot finish on wood? That's sort of what this looks like, but with different angles of the sun, different times of day, sometimes it almost looks like black and blue with the blue sheen to it. It's a fun plant. I really like that. I probably should have gotten more, but I've never grown it before. So I just did some light reading on it. Sounded like it'd be an easy plant to throw in with some other tropicals as an annual. And I can see myself liking this enough that I will probably be lifting this and making sure to take it inside during the winter because it's just so neat looking. Bordeaux infraticosa, looking cute. It's the kiwi, one of my favorites. Not much to say there. And then just one of my favorites, gingers, just rebounding from wintertime. Have that in the background, some portora alocasias right there, ponds, doing its pond thing. I got a net in the mail that I need to put over the top of that, which should be interesting since the plants have already started to grow up and over where the net would need to go. Oh, and I set the power pump on the waterfall to give it a big drink, and looks like the birds knocked it over. Feisty birds, mule palms back there. I'm gonna get a drip line run to those. They need it. They've been thirsty plants. Had a gnat fly right into my eye. Mr. Freckles or Freckles Croton. Look at him. So pretty. Just absolutely love this plant. This just got a repot 2 days ago. I bumped it up. It was in a kind of an awkward size sort of squat 10-inch container, probably an 8-inch container, actually, and I bumped it up to, I want to say it's a 7-gallon container. It fits right into this bubble planter that's down here. It's a perfect fit in that container. Fit right in there. I don't usually pot the tropicals right into heavy pottery, at least not if it's pottery that I really like. That way, when I need to move them in and out during the winter, I can just lift them in their nursery cans, take them inside, and I don't have to worry about breaking their pots. And it reduces the weight, which is nice. Doesn't matter because the Freckles has grown so much that you really can't even see the container that it's in. So maybe I should even rethink that and put something a little bit different in there because that's a really neat looking pot. Although when I finish this area up, this is an area I haven't gotten to yet. I'm working this way. So this is where I've left off. Lots of old pots that need to go, some bonsais that didn't survive that cold blast back in February, so I need to do something with those. But maybe when I have things set up more appropriately and staged properly over here, that'll be more noticeable and more front and center. Hopefully. I can make it work.
I'll get it figured out. The windmill palm planters, I feel like you probably see these in every single vlog. There they are. Got this entire area set up and didn't talk about it in last week's vlog. I did this right around the time that new table and the furniture was delivered. Robellini here. Big white bird of paradise over here that has some cordylin fruticosas in it. And I left some of the Maui gold colocasias in that planter last fall when I pulled it, just to see what they would do, how they would survive, and they're coming back. There's all kinds of little green growths down there, so I'm super pumped about that. I'm gonna have a whole bunch of them to play around with this year. Persian shield in the back, dragon wing begonia on each side, frog in a blender caladium coming up right in the center by that palm trunk. All doing well, but you know, it's only been a couple weeks, so not much to see with those yet. Sun patient, rose veined, very vibrant. It's one of those plants where I love it, but also sometimes it's so loud that I'm like, ugh, I don't know, like it might be too much. Sometimes I fight with my own preferences in my head and instead should just embrace them. Like leopard print, some people love it. Go ahead and wear it, who cares? I feel like this plant is kind of like the leopard print of a plant. It's very in your face, but it's pretty, so it's fine, who cares. Cupfia, I believe this one's called Honey Bells. One of my favorite cupfias, the hummingbirds love it, and it is a pinkish color, a pinkish red. On camera it's gonna look more red. I don't think I saved its tag, but I wish I had. Like I said, I'm pretty sure it's called Honey or Honey Bell, maybe something like that. I'm not positive. That's done a lot of growing though. It's really enjoying this exposure that it's getting for the way the sun comes through. A plant that's not enjoying the exposure in this spot, the dahlias. Yeah, it turns out the afternoon sun combined with the pavement and everything, too much. I gotta move those. It's really cool right now and it hasn't been too sunny, so I'm not worried about them at this exact moment, but they've gotta go somewhere else. They're just frying to a crisp. I've done a little bit of deadheading on them this morning. I'll get the rest of that done in a little while, but it's just, yeah, they don't look good. I have a little bitty one down here that's looking a lot better. Down here in front of that lavender, it's more shaded, so it hasn't been getting cooked like the rest of the plants have right there. Done better than the ones that were. Yeah. Oops. I'll be okay. I'll give them a nice rejuvenation prune, plop them in the ground, they'll take off. The hanging basket from the springtime, still here, still doing well. The dianthus started to melt off of the middle, so I hung a shiny little chandelier thing from Amazon in there. I actually completely love. I think it looks really pretty there, especially at nighttime. It sparkles with the lights on in the background behind it. All the plants in here are doing pretty well. For the most part, all cool season plants. The snow princess alyssum, they can take some heat. Those have been bred well to take more heat. Same thing with the creeping Jenny, but all the pansies that are in there, I just assumed that those were going to fade out by now, so I'm surprised it's even still going. But that's just more of a testament to how unseasonably cool it's been. We've had some days that are pretty warm, and it shows, especially on like this alyssum right here, the dark night. I had higher hopes for that alyssum. I'm not too impressed. I planted some of those last year and they performed in a fairly similar fashion. Croton's flushing out with new leaves. It's getting really big. I was going to do my summer hanging basket with all Super Tunia Vistas, but I don't think there's gonna be room there for that. I might have to rethink that plan. But yeah, Croton's adjusting well. This is just how it looks when I bring it out in the springtime, but it's already flushing out with new growth. It's gonna look like a brand new plant here in just a few weeks. In this bed right here, I do have a few plants laying out that need to get potted up. Sun patient needs to get potted up right there. I have another lantana needs to go down here. Originally, all of these sun patients were like a pretty bubblegum pink, and well, not so much now. Now they're more of a light purple. Hopefully that's just a temperature thing and they will go back to being a nice pink vibrant color when things warm up. Lantana hasn't done much yet. They have actually, they put on a good amount of growth, but they haven't quite got into their groove with flowering. They are absolutely covered in flower buds though. I have one doing a lot of flowering right here and the rest have lots of buds on them, but not much going on with the flowers, not just yet. The Tradescantias, they're hanging in there. I don't think they've been appreciating the off and on weather either, but they're starting to do some growing. I think as things warm up, those should take off and start to look an awful lot better too. Here's hoping anyways. I have a Rolia here. This is the Macho Morado, one from Proven Winners. It's done a good amount of growing. It's like really rooted itself in there. I have a drip run right to it. They like lots and lots and lots of water. They need warmer nights to bloom, so it's probably still gonna be a minute until I start to see any flowers on this. Usually by this time of year, it'll be in the 70s and 80s at nighttime, but instead it's been in the 40s. We'll get there. Before we know it, it's gonna be piping hot out here. So that'll start to put on a beautiful show. It will look nice when it gets going. The flowers look like, kind of like purple petunias. A nice light purple petunia. Red palms, one on each side of the queen palm. doing well. Those of them haven't been there very long, so I don't expect much out of them. But each one of these plants has put up, I think, 2 new leaves, which is more than I even would have expected, considering I haven't, I think it's only been, what, a month and a half, maybe, if even, since I got those planted. They've been growing well. Same thing down here with the ginger. This is a flaming torch ginger. I always forget. I always want to call it fiesta. It's flaming torch. I have those spread around the entire garden. There's one clump there. I did have one transplanted to the spot last year so that they would come up and frame each side of the window. But the one that was transplanted right here didn't come back, and then there was one that got planted on the opposite side of the gate near that Washingtonia. That didn't come back either, which is not at all surprising. Who put that pole there? Come on. Which is not at all surprising considering how incredibly cold it got last winter. I'm really pleased and surprised and shocked that any of them are coming back. I have one clump here, one clump there, then another one right there. So this is only their second year in the ground. That's why there's not much to them. But the idea here is that they'll come up nice and tall on each end right here and then be just at the base of that window. Flowers on them come up nice and big, a little bit over a foot, and they're covered in orange flowers. The pollinators love them. I'm gonna love being able to see that through the window with the palm tree, the oleander, the bananas in the background, and having all the hummingbirds and butterflies right outside. It's gonna be so pretty. I'm really excited about that. This entire area though is still a disaster because working my way around. I have some perennials ready to go in the ground over here. Still waiting on getting some mulch. I actually have spent the bulk of my time in this area working on plumbing. There are a bunch of busted pipes and sprinkler heads and those sorts of things. So I've been digging things up, getting all that repaired so that the area can be finally put together. I had to like completely redo majority of the plumbing over here and the drip because there were leaks coming from like 3 different spots and different fittings. That's not supposed to be there. That's just where it is right now. No, I'm not one of those people who picks up and makes things nice and tidy for garden tours. I probably should, but I think of a garden tour more as like a progress report as opposed to a look at how amazing everything is. It's more like, hey, here's what I've done. Here's what I want to do. Here's what's happening. There's always projects going on out here. To have things looking totally tidy, that's a big ask. Probably not going to happen here on this channel, at least not in the month of May or June. Look, that's not happening. Need more time to get more things done. I have a banana and a passion flower that are going to go back here in this corner. I need to get this whole area re-leveled out, get the rocks moved around. Probably going to fill this container with lemon coral sedum with a fun, colorful centerpiece. And I was thinking about filling the rest of the area. And why am I that's going to be a surprise. Got to wait for that video. I'm going to fill this area, though, with lots and lots of color. Super Petunia Vista bubblegums. No surprise, looking fantastic. The spotlights are on. That's how cloudy it is. The lights think that it's nighttime. The heliconias that are in here haven't done much yet. They're going to need some heat to get moving. So for now, they're just hanging out, sitting still, looking sad, waiting for summer, which like I said, it'll be here in a few days. Before we know it, it's going to be out here talking about how it's too hot and the plants are burning up. The joys of working outside with the plants. The banana clumps are looking great. You know, I wasn't even sure if they were going to come back after that winter, but they're here and they're nice and big. This clump and the other one looking fantastic. Heck, they even look better than they did last year. This time last year, this one was in shambles because there was a sick magnolia tree here that had to get cut down. All the limbs came down and all that fresh growth that was right there. So I'm pleased just to see how nice these are looking. I think it was probably around early to mid-June. Well, I guess that's pretty much where we are right now until they started to even remotely have this many leaves on them. They were a little bit shorter. Tree came down on top of them. Blue dune grass is looking great. It's a messy plant. It's not something for a really nice refined garden. It has the ability to fill in a space and naturalize it and add a lot of contrast. It's simple to grow. It looks beautiful pretty much all year. I mean, you know, in the winter, it's just brown and dry grass. There's seed heads. There we go. There's seed heads stand nice and high above that foliage. They move in the wind. That movement and texture. I absolutely love this grass. Not something I would plant in an area where it couldn't be contained though. Like if I had a garden bed that was going out into the landscape, well, maybe I would. I probably would, but I would say that I shouldn't because it does spread very quickly and pretty aggressively. But it's blue. Who doesn't love blue? Oh, another contrast. Aucubas. Aucubas sparkling burgundy. No flowers on that yet. I need to move this clump. Because what happens in this spot every year is that the bananas end up getting nice and huge, as bananas do, and they tend to shade it. And then you can barely even see the flowers on them. They still come back every year and grow well. They even still flower. Might be better this year, though. I don't know, because the trunks or the pseudostem had so much growth that survived on them that their foliage is starting off pretty high instead of years past where there would be a lot of low foliage that shades this very heavily. Maybe that'll make a difference. I don't know. If not,
have a good spot for them over here. They'll get a lot of sun. Plants cook over here. A lot of sun reflects from the patio up onto the house and back down.
Like a little oven. It's a good place to send plants to die.
I'm just kidding. Most of what's over there has been doing really well.
This is the Gartenmeister fuchsia that I was saying I need to make sure to talk about. I've been putting them in hanging baskets just because it makes them easier to move around. And that's because this time of year they can take a lot more sun when things are cool. When it gets really hot out, I move them to where they'll be getting part shade to part sun.
And the handle on there is nifty. Since I move them around a lot, it's not really necessary. But it's just my preference with these. I like to have them hanging up because the hummingbirds, they go nutty over these flowers.
This one's been getting a lot of sun, but it hasn't been very hot outside, so it can take it. And the variegation on this one, so fun and colorful. Love, love, love this plant. Persephone crinum lily. That's it. Not much to say. It's not in flower yet. I have a whole bunch of pumpkins. Over here, there are pumpkin seeds everywhere because last fall carved pumpkins. It's just threw the guts out into the garden, and now pumpkins. I'll need to do something with that, but for now, it's okay. Mimosa tree's flushing out. Hadn't mentioned that. There it is. That's it for all of the changes and what's going on out here. Starting to get moving on some fun projects. A little bit of sunburn there on the Robolini. It's okay.
Oh, and then I've been organizing orchids over here on the table.
Bringing them out, getting them ready to be placed. Love the orchids, such pretty plants. This one back here, this one right here, this has been in bloom since I got it back in December. Never in my life had an orchid that bloomed for this long. It's been in bloom for about 6 months. Isn't that amazing? Wish I knew what the variety name was. I've been keeping an eye out trying to find another one whenever I'm at the big box stores. It didn't have a cultivar name on it, so who knows what it is. I would imagine not a popular one for the mass orchid sellers, the mass breeders, because they think that they kind of rely on the orchids dying or the flowers dying and people throwing away and buying new ones. So having one that stays in bloom this long, probably not super popular, but if anybody has an idea, let me know, because I'd like to have another one. If I had two of these, I could have one in bloom all year. They can stay looking this nice for 6 months. It's nuts. The colors change on it too. It was like a really pretty pink color and they're fading into more of a, well, you can see it, whatever you'd call that. It's less pink, but still, absolutely beautiful. And now it's time to get going on bulbs, tubers, rhizomes. Normally things that I would do earlier in the month, but it's with the erratic weather, just didn't get around to it. Lots of dahlias, caladiums, whole bunch of fun things. Those are gonna be getting in the ground here pretty soon. And that's it. That wraps things up. That's everything that's been going on out here. Lots of fun things to come. Just getting started. I love it. I'm so happy to be outside and playing with the plants again. Hope everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.